fan seats. That is a section of the Dundee support looking at the team who, if they win today, could possibly gain a European place. And at the other end, the Dundee United supporters watching their team playing for the last time in the league before the cup final next Saturday. A perfect setting for what ought to be a perfect football match. Pitch looks in very good condition, but I think it'll be slightly hard. Players were skidding about in the warm-up before the game. John Brown, player of the year for Dundee, not surprisingly. Rafferty. Walker McCall ran away for that, and by the way, as Hamish McAlpin picks that up, United are back to the strongest possible team, and they may be giving their cup final side a run out this afternoon with Gobb, Hegarty and Neri back in the side. Now guess who that is. Come on, turn around, David. There you are. Davy Syme, referee. Kick to United. Billy Kirkwood. Well, he doesn't get away with it. There's Walker McCall in the left back position, but it's a throw to United. Very quickly taken. Stoddart. That's Taylor. Just a little too hasty. Right down the side. Stever. Well, the fans won't be shouting for more of this. Very bitty indeed. Well, that's a better ball. The best touches have come from Sturrock so far, and then he gets one. Can he go through the middle? Oh, brilliant tackle. Well, I thought it was. Oh, the referee indicating a hand. Tackle all right, but he saw him handling. I thought it was a superb tackle by McKinley. However, it's a free kick. Typical defensive wall with John Holt in it. Or Ralph Bill, sorry, Milner's in there. Oh, it was Bannon who took the last one. He does it again. Oh, Bobby Guinness, the equal of that. Watch him coming in. That was on target. Much better than the last one. Taylor all being hauled back. And another booking. Third booking. So, Bannon with it. That's a leap, and that's... Ooh, it's almost in from Sturrock. Oh. The almost perfect header. Cormack. Lights run through, north side. Marvellous chance. Rafferty, that's it, yes. Beautifully put in. Really superbly shot home. Goal there by Connor. Oh, what quick retaliation. Run there by Rafferty. And in it went from Connor. 1-0 for Dundee on the half hour. What a pity for United. That ball almost went into net from Sturrock. I think the decoy was Richard Goff when he went up. Disguised the run by Sturrock, and that header right off the post. Taylor. Well, in the middle. Ooh, and Bannon comes in. Dundee players didn't like that. And the referee hasn't stopped the play. There's no free kick. Bannon. There's McCormick. Stephen. Nice run by Stephen Rafferty. Well, I think if we run that back, we'll see that Hamish McAlpin anticipated that little chip round. Down he went. Bit of a tangle. Taylor. Goff. It was a good jump by Milne. It wasn't really Bannon. Right to the goal line, and he gets another corner. And barely time to take it. We are into injury time. The halftime whistle goes. Enthusiastic applause way down at the end there from the Dundee supporters. Delighted at that scoreline. But in fact, let's look at the entire incident. That header, firstly, by Paul Sturrock. As I said, it was Richard Goff that was a decoy, and he got his header in. That was desperately unlucky, you know. Break anybody's heart to see that perfect header coming back. And the counter-attack was more than the equal of it. Superbly taken goal, a modern goal. Indeed, get a team attacking and put the ball downfield. Good quality run, control, and an excellent finish. That's what it's all about. And with 45 minutes to go, Dundee are looking definitely very good. And you can see with Paul Sturrock there, the substitute Coyne has come on for Dundee United. Tommy Coyne, who played from the start against Rangers last week. And he's on. That's a little bit surprising. I don't know whether it's a tactical change by Jim McLean or an injury. Coyne is on. Ralph Milne who's off. There's a race through by Rafferty. That's Stephen nearly stepping in. Rafferty, been a busy little man today. Did that in the first half as well. And he gets a corner kick. That's just for what? Good honest sweat. Something at the end of the day. Now Connor. All his corner kicks swinging far too wide. McCormack. No. Well off. Here's Goff. Done by Bannon, but getting himself into a bit of a fankle. But a kick with Hills and tells Bannon exactly what he ought to have done. Kick it out of the park. In there by Kidd, that looked threatening. Rafferty again, no free kick. Kidd working hard, that's a useful ball. And there's McCall, here's Kidd with a chance. Easily taken, that should have been cut back. However, Albert Kidd has certainly contributed a lot since he's come on as sub. Getting that chance by McCall, awkwardly bouncing. Nevertheless, I think he had very little chance of beating McAlpin from that angle. No free kick. Goff. Intelligent play, Billy Kirkwood. Oh, there's a chance! Taylor. A distinct chance. Mark, I don't blame the young player for taking it first time, because the pitch is very fiery indeed. And if he tried to control it, well, you never know. The ball might have bounced off, would have let it come down, and I think, although that showed no control, the intent was there. McCormack. Taylor did well, he got away with it, and it's actually 4-3. Bannon. Oh, he couldn't get it over properly. There's Taylor again. That's Bannon. That's a better ball, and it's off the line. Billy Kirkwood ought to have put that away. Really dreadful miss by United. Look at that, inviting ball, good header, confused Geddes, and Dundee survive. Dab forward, and Hamish McAlpin's there. That's not a bad ball. Coyne. What has been given? Penalty kick. Has it? What has the linesman given? Yes, a penalty. It was right on the edge of the box. There's no question about that. And I wonder if in our replay we can judge it. There's a run forward, and oh dear, it's difficult to say. If we look at it again as they go forward, the linesman was right in line, certainly, and down he went, very, very close indeed. But the penalty given. Bannon protected. And he saved it. The roof's coming off this enclosure. No wonder. For this save, he judged it perfectly. Although, to be honest, not the best penalty kick Bannon's ever taken. Well, guess who they support? Coyne. Oh, it's a bit too dainty. They get a free kick out of it. Quickly taken. Paul Sturrock trying to turn. High one. Look to come off. Alec Taylor's arm. Play goes on though. There's Hamish McAlpin. Not much to do in the second half. There he is. Now Sturrock. Oh, touched nicely. Coyne! Can't put it away. Very good save by Geddes. I did notice away in the back of the stand, as I said that, Jim McLean applauding. I'm quite sure both this neat little move and that excellent save. Here's Sturrock. Oh, can Dundee hold out? There's a great shot. They are really trying now. It's all about pride. They've got a cup final to face next week. But the thought of going back even down the road with a defeat stings them. There he is, turning, and it's puffs of dust left in its trail. Seconds remaining, still one goal in it. And United still have a big task in front of them next week. Bit awkward, Goff. But off with a D-man. seconds to go. All the Dundee supporters' eyes on that man in the white shirt, Davy Sine. Now, just the last effort by United. It's well cleared, Goff. Bit slow going for that, but he gets a free kick, and we're in injury time. Shadows Lentney, ready to take it. Season 85 almost at an end, and it's harmlessly passed. Bobby Geddes will be in no hurry to take this. There he is, Davy Sine. You know, a long, tiring season for referees and players. Now, United again. Neri, wrong side of Paul Sturrock. That will go out of touch, but I don't think they're particularly caring about that. We're now over a minute into injury time. Taylor, that's it. Dundee have won the local derby. And onto the field come some of the supporters, which really ought not to happen. But in any case, have had a fine ending to the season. And off troop the players, and I'm sure. But although they enjoy the game of football, they'll be glad to see the end of that one, a local derby on the last day of the season, and with United to face a cup next week.
Well, that was the final score, 1-0, and indeed deserving to get these 2 points. It was